Career Impulse, let's talk. Today we are at Delhi Public School, Srinagar, the most beautiful school in the valley, as you can see behind me. And today here we have some bright students and a counselor, Ms. Munazza Arif Beg. Welcome to the show, guys. So let you introduce yourself to our viewers first.
This is Naisin Arif, 12th Medical.
Okay.
This is Muskan Shafat, 12th Class Humanities.
This is Huzaifa Jilani, Class 12th Humanities.
I am Haseeb Saqib from Class 12th Med Plus Mathematics stream.
I'm Kausan Qureshi from Humanities Class 12th.
I am Ahtisham Bashir, Humanities Class 12th.
This is Zoya Zafar, Class 12th Medical.
So friends, do you remember the time when we used to write letters or when people used to wait for a call? There was a time when people were excited about a single mail, but today time has changed. Actually, social media has changed everything. We don't bother to see each other face to face. So today we are discussing these things with the guests here, and the topic will be social media affecting the relationships. Let me start with you first. You just tell me honestly, how much time do you give to social media, and then how much time do you give to your family? Just be honest.
Very less time is given to the family. You know, I go home, I grab my phone first, then I ask for my mother, where is she? First I start chatting with my friends, then I ask my mom, how are you? So very less time is given to the family rather than friends.
Just pass the mic to him. Let me know from you, how much time do you give to social media and then to your family?
If we have 24 hours in a day, right, 20 hours are like to the social media and 4 hours to myself and my family and other friends, like who are around me. So major of my time goes with social media.
That means major time goes to social media. Okay, just pass the mic. What about you?
I think 80% of my time goes to social media. Right. When I go home, I first use Facebook and then Twitter, then Instagram. I have no time for books also, leave apart my family.
Okay. What's your take on this? How much time you give to social media and then to family?
No doubt I use social media a lot. I must say that 20% of my time goes with the social media, but I use it for informative purposes. Okay. You know, for example, we take the example of Facebook. I've liked many informative pages of science, religion, and I just read the posts.
Okay, that gives me impression you may be the topper of your class, right?
No, ma'am, it's not like
okay, so pass the mic.
Social media, what happens is that as soon as we reach home, there's this urge to check the Facebook, right, how many notifications, messages, and what happens is that ek ghante ke liye kar lungi and then I'll study, but that ek ghanta is just doesn't end.
Okay, fine. Yeah, you?
I have a different take actually. Okay. I'm not such a huge social media buzzer.
Right.
I am on all social media apps, but I don't spend so much time on it, just because I believe it's something which is more productive is spending time with yourself, right, and reading books and everything else. So for me, it's the tale is different because I am not a social media buzz.
That's strange. Yeah.
I would say I'm the same teeny booper like anybody else out here. Right. Whenever I go home, the first thing I do, open the fridge and check where my phone is actually. It's on the fridge or somewhere else. I need to see the texts. Yeah. And then maybe if I get time, spending time with my family. That's the second reason.
Okay. That means that most of you give, maximum time to social media, right? Now, just tell me that staying on social media for so long, does it affect your relationships with your family somehow?
I think the life we live as being the friends with people on the social media, it's a virtual world. It's the virtual world of fantasies. We just, when we text to someone, we don't include those emotions that we are feeling at that time while texting to someone. If you talk to some friend face to face, I think we would be able to better communicate with that person.
Yeah, okay, that was take from a student. Now let's talk to the counselor, Ms. Munazza. Will you please tell us that how does the social media, time spending on social media, affect the relationship with the family?
When we talk about the positive aspect of it, it really helps us to be in contact with the friends, to be in contact with the relatives, to be in contact with our loved ones. That's the plus point. But when we look for the dark side of the social media, its influence on the relationship, it's really very drastic. We're not able to develop that empathetic and affectionate attitude for the real life situations. Because what we all know about is just to text a person, if he is sad, nothing will happen, it's okay. But we're not able to really relate to the people, understand their problems. So this way, it is affecting. We are not able to spend time. Again, we are not able to understand. When I talk about the children, specifically about the teenagers, they have more of a times they have the need to widen their social circle,
right,
because it's their stage. And at this point of time, what happens is that the teenagers allow to spend more of their times with the peers instead of with the parents.
True.
But when we talk about the social networking sites, what they are doing, they are adding up the fuel to the fire. Already, teenagers are not interested in spending time with the parents. And this thing, when the phones, all time they're having their phones, I may not say that this thing happens with each and every child. Exceptionals are there, as we can have two kids from there.
Right.
But then when we talk in general, so they're getting a platform wherein they can spend most of their time on the social networking
True.
Sites, like relationship stuff.
Yeah.
That becomes a platform for them to satisfy and gratify all these needs. And this is a thing that's easily accessible to them. So this is, it's affecting the relationship at the home, the relationship of the kids with their parents. Again, when we talk about the adults in the family, like I'll talk about myself, when I'm there in the family, I'm sitting with my in-laws, I'm sitting with my husband, but then this phone, if I'll message my brother, if I'll message any of my friends,
right.
every time I'm having this thing in my mind, I'm not getting a reply. Is my friend annoyed with me? What's wrong? So all these things
the
are there on my mind.
Already.
So my mind is all time it's preoccupied, and I feel in stress all the time, and I'm not able to give my time. That okay. frustration, that confusion.
Means there is a strain in the relationship.
Definitely,
you're
yes,
preoccupied,
it is.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay, fine, thank you. May I know from you, like, you just be honest, okay? How many friends you have on Facebook and how many friends you have on social media? Like, do you have more friends in real life or on social media?
I only add people whom I really know.
Okay.
At least they have to be my acquaintances. So I have about 100 friends on Facebook. Most of them are from my batch or the teachers
okay,
or my
most
friends.
Most of them. 100, you just know all of them?
Yes, ma'am.
In,
I know all
face?
Of them. Yes, I know
okay,
all of
that's,
them.
Okay, that's very good. Yeah, please, you add something to it.
Everybody is saying all the negative things. I guess I would speak some positive
yeah,
now.
Sure.
The thing is, what I'll talk about myself, I had recently opened a Facebook account. So I was not there on Facebook from a very long time.
Okay.
But the thing with Facebook and me is that it has helped me to connect with people who are very far away from me. Talking about consoling, sometimes it's not always for a person to be there and counsel you and tell you this is wrong or this is right. Sometimes few words, are you okay? Like, I'm there for you. It really matters. So these things are possible only because of social media.
But it means your take is that social media somehow helps in deepening the relationships, right?
Yeah, for me, it has
okay.
helped me a lot because my friends who are not with me right now, living, in other places, I am in contact with them only and only because of social media. And when I have some issues that I cannot discuss with my father,
okay.
issues that I cannot discuss with my mother, issues that I cannot relate to myself, but I can relate it to my friend. So
okay.
this is the only source that has helped me and get through
yeah,
it.
Yeah, you want to add up something? Yeah, sure.
So we are all different, right?
Right.
And I have this to say, some people are not very expressive. They are not very vocal with their voice, but they are very creative with their words and they can text very beautifully. So everybody does not have solace in their parents, because if we are struck by the phenomenon of social media, so are our parents. If we are busy on social media, well, they are as well.
Right.
So there is this generation gap as well as this social media drift that is occurring between us. Therefore, sometimes what we are going through, we believe maybe our parents are showing us off.
Yeah.
Maybe they are busy in their work or social media itself.
Right.
So it is at that point in time, we look at who is online, and amongst them, we see, okay, this person can understand and I can talk to them.
Okay.
So in a way, it's
yeah.
actually
okay,
something
okay.
which is connected.
Okay. Is there increase in the development of online network connections rather than face-to-face relationship? Means
yes.
that online connections are growing rather than the face-to-face.
If I'll talk about our culture or our system within the family, the mother, she is busy with the household work or she is working. The father, he's busy with the office work or
right,
whatever.
Right.
So the child is there and he's not, the parents, we are not able to give time to one another. We are so busy in our schedules. So what happens, in order to gratify that emotional support, instead of getting it from the parents, instead of getting it from our friends, what we do, we try to gratify these needs from the social networking sites. So this somehow somewhere is the biggest reason that we'll find nowadays people more on the social networking sites and these relationships are increasing.
When we come to relationships, you know, isn't social media giving a platform to ignore face-to-face relations? Like you said, when you feel your parents are not giving you time, your siblings or friends are not giving you time, you have an option. So you ignore them and you move on to social media. Doesn't that mean it's giving a platform to negate or to ignore the relationships in real life?
As I said, that it's both the positive factors are there, the negative factors are there. Now, depending upon the usage of a person, how many hours? As many of the students said that, one of the students even said that he is using social networking sites 20 hours.
Yeah, right.
And 4 hours he is giving it to the family and for himself. So when it's a usage like relating to the friends, as one of the students said, relating to the friends, like the friends were not accessible to me, I'm not able to meet them, they are at the other places.
Right.
So at this point of, from this very point of view, we can say that it's a good thing. But when it comes to excessive usage, then it's creating problem.
So let me hear from you, just be honest again, I'm saying. Do you think, like when you see an update on social media from a friend, like unki family kahin ja rahi on an outing, or he has got something new, some new gadget or a new bike, so you just think something negative about your own family, ki aapko aise apne relations mein strain aata hai ki that guy is getting so much, I'm not getting it. So is it like
it's
that?
ये मतलब सोशल ये सोशल नेटवर्किंग का कसूर नहीं है. इट हैपेंस इफ आई से लाइक वी आर हैविंग फेस टू फेस कांटेक्ट विद दिस फ्रेंड एंड शी सेज दैट हर फादर गॉट हर समथिंग.
ओके,
ये तो ऐसे भी होगा.
बट सोशल मीडिया पे शो ऑफ ज्यादा होता है. यू नो यू गो टू अ सिंपल प्लेस,
यू डिपेंड्स ऑन पर्सन टू पर्सन.
ओके, सो उस पे जब आप देखते हैं कुछ, डज इट अफेक्ट योर रिलेशनशिप विद योर ओन फैमिली दैट मुझे ऐसा नहीं है या मेरे साथ ऐसा नहीं होता?
नहीं,
समवेयर
इट डिपेंड्स. आई एम रिपीटिंग, इट डिपेंड्स, इट डिपेंड्स कि हाउ यू टेक इट.
आई जस्ट वांट टू नो फ्रॉम यू, डू यू थिंक दैट द यूज ऑफ सोशल मीडिया हैज अफेक्टेड यू मेंटली? लाइक एज आई सेड, यू आर प्री ऑक्यूपाइड, सो हैज इट अफेक्टेड यू मेंटली? यू आर विद योर फ्रेंड्स बट स्टिल थिंकिंग about the social media, the inbox. So does have it affected you?
It happens with me. Like if I'm sitting with my friends,
right,
I just take out my phone and check ki us dost ne kya reply kiya hoga. So this thing happens kahin bhi ho, koi bhi ho, aajkal yahi hota rehta hai, this always
happens. Okay, so what's your take? Will you add something?
When I'm sitting with you, I'm looking at you but my mind is somewhere else. I'm thinking about wo chat kahan gayi, I was talking about something and I had to stop because I had to go to school. I'm looking at my teacher, listening to what he's saying, but my mind is on Facebook. I have to see how many people liked it, how many people commented on my status, what they thought about what I'd written, be it a poem or anything, whatever it is.
So let me tell you that, do you think social media is increasing the fakeness in the relationship? Just be honest, tell any incident of your life where you have met a fake friend or you agree that there is fakeness because of social media.
Sure, what happens is that, as someone already mentioned, on Facebook we create ourselves. In reality, we are what we are, but in Facebook, we have the option to show people what we want them to see about us. So we like put forward the good things about us. I'm like this, I'm like this. But when we actually see the person in reality, he's a total opposite of this.
Okay.
This did happen to me once. So there was this guy who was, you know, but in the end, he turned out to be
fake.
And this does happen to people. You know, sometimes what happens is that just to keep check on a particular girl, a guy creates an account with the name of a girl who moved away 4 years
princess
ago. So
Angel,
you never
something.
Know who's it.
Right?
You see, you never know. Yes, Princess yeah. Alia or something. So he does use the name of a girl, for example, who moved away 4 years ago. You never know if this is the person or it's not. And in the end, he turns out to be someone else altogether.
That
this
fakeness is growing, yeah?
Yes,
there
fakeness
can't
is
be fakeness when you're face to face. Now you can know the person, you know the body language, the expressions, everything.
Yeah. Still, okay. Again comes the phenomenon of being positive side and negative side. It's not every time that you can, you know, find someone, talk to him face to face. Facebook or, you know, social network, somewhere along the line, it's very quick. We can contact the person in a minute. There's something wrong with us, we contact the person we need and he helps us out.
This okay. Any of you wants to add an incident related to this fakeness? You have been a victim or something?
No, I would like to say that this is becoming a fabrication kind of a thing. You
True.
Know, we like being people who always want to be good at things. We always try to put ourselves at the best place. I have the best watch. You know what? My father gave me 1 lakh, so I bought it. This is these are the things that we mostly see on Facebook. You know what? Today I went with my mother. You know what? I went to the best restaurant ever. So this is the thing that we fabricate. We let people know what we have the best. We are the best. We are gonna be the best. We will have the best. So the best thing that is happening, prevailing in our society, prevailing in the minds of the people, this is what is hampering our culture.
Now, don't you think that today you show your anger, even your anger on social media? Like if you're angry with someone, you just block them out on Facebook and WhatsApp, and that's it. If you are face to face, you just say even hi, but then you just block them out on Facebook and WhatsApp. Is this so? Do you agree?
No, it's not always like that. For example, our exams are going and someone keeps on messaging us more and more every day, and they're pestering us. So we just block him, not out of anger, but you know, we don't want them there for a particular period of time. You know, there are different reasons for blocking people. It's not out of anger always.
Okay, so will you add something to it? Yeah.
Ma'am, I agree with you. What we do earlier when we used to fight with our friends face to face, then they used to say sorry and everything was all right. But nowadays what we do, we block the friend and we don't give them a chance even to say sorry or anything. We just cut off everything with them and it creates a space, a vacuum between the friends, and it destroys our relations with them.
Yeah, sure.
But the blocking option is a good option. Like, you know why? Because I cannot block if she's sitting in front of me. I cannot block her. Nahi, baat mat kar mere se. But on Facebook, if she's texting me, kya 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 wagera wagera, I can block her. Baad mein dekhte hain.
Now, I will just ask each one of you, tell me honestly, what do you think? Is it better to talk on daily basis with your family and friends, or is it better to talk to a friend daily but on social media? What do you think personally, each one of you?
No, it is better to talk to a family and friends face to face rather than talking to someone on media, because we get to know better face to face rather than on media.
Okay, so what's your take on
this? Same, I agree with Zoya that if we talk to face to face to our parents, they can share emotions, like agar wo kuch bol rahe hain to usme kuch emotions hogi, which we lack in social networking sites.
True. Okay, your take on this?
I think on social media the biggest problem is you cannot see the expressions. There's always a term, every term has a gold mine full of meanings and expressions. When I say good, somebody would take it, ha, good. Then there is no, if it's so good, he will not understand this thing, he will not understand my anger. I think face to face communication is so much better than the virtual world
communication. Okay,
ma'am, agar hum communication ki baat kare to 70% jo communication hai wo hamare gestures, hamare facial expressions se hum convey kar pate hain. लेकिन जो 30% है वो लैंग्वेज, इसीलिए जब हम सोशल मीडिया पे बात करते हैं वो तो 70% ऑफ आवर कम्युनिकेशन इट्स लॉस्ट पहले ही, बाद में. दूसरी बात, जब हम फेस टू फेस बात करते हैं हम किसी के बोले बिना ही उसकी फीलिंग्स को समझ पाते हैं कभी कभी, या हम उसको वी कैन रियली फील व्हाट ही इज थिंकिंग अबाउट एनीथिंग. तो इसीलिए मेरे हिसाब से फेस टू फेस कन्वर्सेशंस आर बेटर देन
Yes, face-to-face conversations are certainly better, because it's not every time that we have, sometimes we just don't want to say anything to anyone. We just sit in a corner and we're just sulking there. Only the person who sees us that time will understand that something is wrong with us. In that case, the person being our parents or anyone else. The person who's face-to-face there with us, not the person who's on Facebook. I mean, come on, it's not every time you will have the strength to, you know, open your phone and tell someone that I'm feeling low and all that. That's not going to happen. So face-to-face relations are certainly.
Okay, face-to-face, right.
I would agree. And this is because when you are face-to-face with somebody, you are actually connecting with that person. It's not using a medium. So you are not using a gadget to connect to that person, rather that person is sitting right in front of you and you are sharing your heart. Sometimes we are not very open in expressing all of our feelings in terms of words. So our facial expressions or maybe our tears are enough for them to understand the gravity of what we are facing.
Okay,
so I would agree.
About parents, I feel that we certainly have a gap between, I have a gap with my parents, everybody does. So what happens is that there was a time when parents were the same teenagers.
Right.
They did the same thing. They did double, I guess. But they don't remember the state now. So things grow, there is a difference of opinion, there's a difference of thinking. So what happens...
But there was not social media at that time.
Yeah, that we don't understand one another. So what happens, we need to have those face-to-face conversation with our parents. We need to understand one state and level. Because they were the same at that time, but they don't remember that state. But we are, you know, we are going through all this. So we need to understand one another and develop a mutual understanding.
Now moving to Ms. Munaza, what do you think, what is better, talking to a family and friends on daily basis or talking to a social media friend on daily basis?
You should be there on the social media, interact with the friends, make new friends, widen your social circle. But then it's better to spend more of the time with your parents and with your family members and with the people, with your friends.
Okay.
to interact face-to-face.
So I can say all of you here said that face-to-face interactions are better than the social media interactions, right? And I can conclude that this generation is, you know, they know everything, what is good and what's bad. They are just misunderstood by the people that they are going on the wrong track. The viewers, you can see that all of them said that no, face-to-face interactions are better. They agree with it. And these were the suggestions they gave about the social media and its impact on relationships. That was all for today. Hope you have enjoyed. If you have any suggestions, do let us know. For now, I am signing off. See you in next episode. Till then, take good care of yourself. Khuda Hafiz.